Can clean shipping make money? It is a complicated issue. In Denmark, where I come from, we normally say, yes, clean ships can make money. We call it quality shipping, just as you do. But it is not an easy task. And we believe in Denmark that these complicated cross-sectoral, cross-border issues are rightly dealt with at the EU level. And that is really one of the areas where EU can add value, in our opinion. And we have tried, as priority area coordinator, to organize this workshop with a view from the ship owners, the innovation project manager, and academia from the projects of the priority area, and also from the fueling side and investment. We have invited speakers. We have Mr. Gintautas Kotka from the Lithuanian Ship Owners Association, Mr. Mirin Hook from the Clean Shipping Index, one of our interesting projects in the area, Mr. Linus Karlsson from the Baltic Maritime Science Park, Mr. Andreas Sutnikas from Martec LNG, and Mr. Kari Granberg from Viking Line. And maybe I could ask you to introduce yourself a little bit more in detail when you have the floor. When the EU strategy was adopted in 2009, Denmark was appointed as coordinator for the priority areas of clean shipping and maritime safety and security. They are called priority areas ship and safe. And the responsibility of the latter we share with our Finnish friends and colleagues. And to anchor this work, we have established steering committees consisting of authorities and relevant actors from across the entire region. And this has proved to be a very efficient way of coordinating the priority areas. And as you know, you've heard several times today, there are three overall objectives in the EU strategy. It is to save the sea, to connect the region, and to increase prosperity. And in our two priority areas, we are so fortunate that we coordinate on behalf of the EU member states around the joint sea, and we clearly contribute to all of these objectives. And that's a very, very interesting thing to do with the projects. To save the sea, we need to think of sustainable transport, quality shipping. And shipping is by far the most efficient mode of transport, as we've heard many times today. And it is when you measure in emission per tons transported cargo. We therefore strongly believe that shipping on the Baltic is not the problem, but that more shipping is a part of the solution. However, also shipping can become cleaner and greener, and that's our ambition for this priority area. From 1st of January 2015 and onwards, as you all know, new rules restricting the sulfur contents of ship fuels will enter into force, which will force ship owners to either upgrade their vessels or to buy low sulfur oil, which is considerably more expensive. And that is really the dilemma. We have already witnessed the closure of two ferry routes in the Baltic. The ferry route from Klaipeda in Lithuania to Sassnitz in Germany was operated by the Danish company DFDS, has closed down, and also the ferry route from Kalundborg to Aarhus in Denmark, operated by the German FRS, has also closed down, and we believe that is because of this dilemma. I know from the Danish ship owners, and maybe we can hear your view a little later, that they strongly support the strong regulation and the strong rules to protect the Baltic Sea and the environment. but also we believe that it is most unfortunate if new regulation meant to protect the environment will lead to modal backshifts, replacing maritime transport, for instance, with more trucks, because maritime transport is very environmentally friendly. And one of the ways to remedy the situation is to develop cheaper and more effective technology to reduce air emissions from ships, engines, and to encourage new and more environmentally friendly fuel as LNG, and I'm sure we'll hear more about that in a minute. In Denmark, we have taken measures to promote and support clean shipping, to encourage retrofit of cleaner technology on board existing vessels, and to introduce new technology. For instance, glass-reinforced plastic and composite materials for construction of small ferries and other types of special purpose vessels. We are well aware that such initiatives will not solve all the sector's difficulties, but we believe that it is a useful contribution. The Danish government has launched a plan for growth in the Blue Denmark in 2012, and I know many other countries have done the same. The aim is to ensure competition, growth, and employment on new maritime areas with growth potential. In Denmark, we see that as ship operations, green maritime solutions, and the offshore sector, and also we see a great potential in the Arctic region. While the maritime sectors are still facing difficulties in many countries, we see similar efforts on blue growth strategies at national level and also at European level. In this context, the study on blue growth, the maritime policy, and for us, very important, the EU strategy for the Baltic Sea region is very, very important. It is important that we continue to cooperate in the Baltic Sea region, in the EU, and in Denmark. We believe that it is also very, very important that we cooperate at the global level in the IMO and on other global forums, as we have also heard today.